Do you want to tell us what all this is about? It looks great. You've got 40 kids turned up tonight. They're all playing football, but you've got some smashing ideas. Do you want to tell us about them?
I will do. Well, first of all, we'll start off with the date. This is Tuesday, the 10th of February 2004. And this area here is, as we call it, the pitch next to St James's Primary School in Calton, Glasgow. So really, to tell you, this pitch has lay empty at night due to the floodlights being broken for the past couple of years. Even though the pitch has been getting used during the summertime and the daytime, obviously...
So you're saying that during the dark nights the kids can't come here and play?
That's it. So, the lads have been invited here to take part in the Calton Player of the Year Award, which was created by the Calton Street League, which was also created in this January 2004 due to the fact that me and three other parents from here were getting fed up with the kids in the house, really. So, we were told, in order to get money to pay for this pitch, to form a committee, which is now known as the Calton Street League. So anyway, the Social Inclusion Partnership are paying for the funding for the pitch for 36 hours, which is all, 36 hours of light, floodlight, which is all we really asked for. You know, I suppose if we'd asked for more, we'd have probably got more. But we only asked for the 36 hours. So during that 36 hours, to get maximum use of the pitch, again, it's the Calton Player of the Year. And in order to do that, the tournament's, I suppose, really, is based upon community unity, whereby the lads don't come down as a team or with a manager. They come down as an individual and they're placed into a team by way of like a player's lottery to get them sort of bought together. And then after...
So this is good because it means all cross-sectarian divides and bigotry and all the rest of it, because you're getting kids, you're bringing kids together.
Well, actually, I have to say, this area of the Calton, I suppose, is quite noted for its unity. Catholics and Protestants are Celtic and Rangers supporters have actually, as far as I know, got on famously together and have done. So there isn't, even though they're maybe surrounded by sectarian issues, I think that's been sort of conquered here.
But also, but brilliant that you put it on record and put it on film, the fact that, you know, the inspirational work you're doing
it's
here.
Really, it's really what this is, I think, is a... The Calton, for whatever it is like a sort of a mile square. So the kids for that end of the Calton don't really know the kids for that end of the Calton. So the sort of players' lottery, they get to know them.
Bring them all together.
And over the course of this tournament, there's people been invited here, like yourself, David Tamer, a spirit aid, who's kindly assisting us with the filming this year. And people who have yet to find out if they're going to turn up. The likes of Gordon Smith, the sports commentator I met today, says he's come down to give us encouragement. Letters were sent out to various organisations who haven't got back to us yet. So I'll let you know when they do, rather than mention them at the moment, right? Just in case they do. But anyway, you can see here, these lads are actually the product of Frank Hughes Senior's, you know, hard work. Frankie is the local, or has been the local football manager here for the past 20 years, and I suppose due to fatigue and lack of help, he sort of went into semi-retirement. You know, we hope this will maybe sort of spur him on to coming back into action.
That would be great. Well, if somebody or your committee take a lot of the pressure off him.
But we're hoping the older lads here, at the end of this tournament, during this tournament, we're hoping to get them to commit themselves to taking this a little bit further. But excuse me, there's also the main issue, the fact that, well, they're allegedly going to be building a housing development on this park.
And this is during the time, just for those of you who are watching this film don't know this, this is the end of a period of maybe 5 years when the city council and the authorities have been closing down inner city areas like this, which is a disgrace, and this is one of the last few that I know that's still surviving. And if they turned this over into flats, it'd be a real disgrace.
Added to that as well is this area, the Calton, has actually no other outdoor recreational facility, you know, free or, you know, or anywhere that you have to pay, you know. So, and it's tarmac, which we don't mind, by the way. So, actually, can I say something?
Aye?
These kids actually here do not know that this is going to get turned into housing development. No, they're not here as a protest, you know, to back that. They're here for the simple reason the lights are on for the first time in 2 years at night.
And congratulations on that. I mean, that's, you know, a big step. And I believe, like, you know, you've been supported. You've been supported by Spirit Aid because we're, you know, doing the filming for you and stuff. But you're also being supported by SIP, aren't you? Social Inclusion Partnership.
Social Inclusion Partnership, with Bill Emerson being the main figure to help us. I think this is Bill's area.
Right.
You know, there's also Ian Mulholland, the community cop, who's given us a lot of support up there. I say Bill funded this tournament. It's the Social Inclusion Partnership through Bill. But Bill's
but through his initiative to go and get the money.
You know, and I'll tell you something. The committee was formed in really January the 4th in the space of like 24 hours when I found out we had to get a committee to pay for the funding for the lets of this part. We formed the committee. I went up to see Bill. Bill said, he listened to me for half an hour and says, start planning that, go ahead with that. You know, we'll fund it. And within the space of maybe 7 to 10 days, we got the lets arranged, and Bill confirmed that the lets, you know, were paid for. Even though we don't have, we're also promised some other equipment, which I believe we will get this week sometime, before the actual start of the competition, which is on, it starts on the 17th. You know,
but that's still brilliant. You think at the beginning of January, and now here we are, what, 5 weeks later or something, and you're ready to pick it off.
That's amazing.
That's fantastic. It's brilliant. Well done, Gary.
Well, and the rest of the lads. Right. Funny enough, there's a lot of things being done here. Well, you think, you know, there's nothing being done. For example, we had to sort of beg, borrow these goalposts here from the power league, which used to be known as the pits in Town Head. We've seen them lying at the back of the pits, and came to the conclusion that we might be able to secure the use of them. We asked for them legally, by the way. The manager, young player, and the head groundsman, Robert, very kindly gave us a loan of them for a month, and says, if you return them, we'll give you two broken sets in return.
That's a start.
But there's other stuff. For example, the park was covered in glass and leaves, which obviously we can't help that, but people breaking glass in it, and then one of the local lads, I have to mention him, Alan Robertson, very kindly gave workers a backhander to come in and clean it. But anyway, that's Alan's method of working, but it get done. But anyway, David, thanks for coming down.
Our pleasure, Gary, and I'll be here during the...
Okay.
Come back again and...
Okay, lovely. Well, it's on for another 3 weeks. And, next Tuesday, Wednesday and Thursday, the 17th, 18th and 19th, from 6 o'clock to 10 o'clock, the first hour for the toddlers. Then at the next hour for the 12-year-olds, working it up to the last hour when sort of big lads have got on the park. That lasts for 3 weeks. The teams get chopped and changed, a bit of community unity. And at the end of it, every player gets a vote on who the Calton player of the year is. You know, for the first
time. See if this guy can play football as well as he can talk. It'd be amazing.
I'm red rotten, by the way. Okay,
thanks, David. Gary.
Right, thanks very much, pal. Brilliant. This is Johnny Nelson. How are you doing, pal?
Bad. Who's our plane?
Well, the Kennedys are bringing their own team down.
Right, who else?
And Daddy's bringing yours down to play. There's a choice of 30 handed to pick for. Well, what would he is David Heyman, right, the actor, who happens to be director of operations for a charity as well called Spirit Aid, is paying for this camera equipment so that we can make this documentary, you know? So really, it's a promotional documentary, so is it hopefully, for we Calton Street League can get more money. Plus, this pitch here is allegedly getting turned into flats.
But who's your team?
It's more or less the new Calton mob, who I've never even heard of any yous. You know what I mean? Yous are non-existent, never stayed here. You meet them in the community, some kind of players. But here, the whole point of this tournament is Calton played in the year 2004, as well as the wee. About the pitch getting flattened, right?
Aye.
So every player has got a vote on who they think's the Calton player of the year 2004. But I don't know, maybe, unless you're outstanding tonight, nobody really knows you, so you might not call for many votes. This is Jamey and Daddy.
How you doing? Daddy's
organising the kind of a glamour game tonight. He's bringing the older Calton team down.
They play
the younger team,
aye.
The thing is, the majority of the younger Calton team don't know they exist.
Well, the man said they're
man actually said that to me there.
Aye, who are you?
He's kidding himself on here.
Palmer was dead.
Roger, we'll get you in a minute. This is Roger Kennedy, one of the Kennedy brothers. How you doing, Roger?
Not so bad, guys. Looking forward to tonight.
See you doing, aye.
Good to see your old camp, my buddy.
He's done well early.
Aye, kid.
Hold on, move on to Robert. Robert Palmer, stunt double. Well,
I'm the coach.
How you doing, Neely?
Fine, thanks. Who's the referee?
Frankie Dunn.
Right.
Where is he?
Shortly.
Right, yeah.
Catch this man, camera shy. Jim Fleming, come to the car here.
Are you alright?
This is the best passer I bought. Allegedly.
Set for the belly.
How you doing, pal?
Not bad.
Good to see you.
Gary, what's your team in, Gary?
The young team are coming down slow. They actually think it's an 8 o'clock kick-off, do they?
Dinner, sorry.
Right, so they'll be
getting early.
There's a few of them here, they know.
If you think you
should bring...
What?
He's better put a couple of corners on that part.
Hiya.
This is Frankie Fun, the referee.
I was a ball boy at Capel Park when Jimmy Cowan, who played for Scotland several times, was a goalie. Aye. Got three bob.
What decade was that?
That was in the early 1950s.
You're merely a rugby man as well, aren't you?
I played rugby when I was at school, and I played after I left school for a wee while.
Did you ever try and introduce rugby to the Calton Club?
Didn't you introduce rugby to the Calton Club? It was there already. Used to play in that old hall and, you know, all these pillars and all the rest of it.
Aye.
Just, like, playing
but
rugby.
Funny enough, one of the other reasons we're here is because they're flattening this football pitch shortly and building hoosies on it. So we don't want them to do another Calton Club stroke and then knock the place, you know, promise that they're going to build another one. So hopefully...
It's a good big pitch.
It's a cracking big pitch.
Hmm. Does it get used a lot?
Well, the lights have been in action for the past 4 years. This is only the second week of football in the past 4 years. Here at night.
Right.
Whereas during the summer it's well used.
Right.
You know?
Aye.
But... They play tennis in the middle when Wimbledon's on and sort of free kicks and corners at the other end. You know, it's a seasonal, multi-purpose sports
space
facility.
Yeah. When did they do this? I mean, it was...
They built
when
it.
I left, last few years I was here, they had made this into a red ash.
Was it?
It was red ash and it was quite a lot smaller.
Yeah. See, I don't want to start the game too early because they're not expected to come down to 8, whereas they and all that. This is an old-fashioned international ploy where we get the rival team done a bit early to perish.
So they all freeze.
No, we don't want to keep the lads waiting. I'll let you go and talk to the lads if you want.
Yes, a Roger boy!
Wait, David.